Hi folks, I am at the market of the small town or village of Lanjak in West Kalimantan in the Indonesian part of Borneo. It's quite a small town or village, but it's the only one for thousands of miles around, so the farmers come here to sell their products. Still, it's a little bit of a disappointing market for me, but that's maybe because I am just coming from the great market of Betong on the other side of the border. Let's see what they got here. There is some langsat, some unripe papaya fruit. Here is some Durio Coteensis and about six Durio Civetinos, but the Durio Civetinos season seems to be pretty much over, so they are selling Durio Coteensis everywhere. Some unripe bananas, some rice. This looks white, so it could be some rice produced somewhere else, because the rice they produce here is usually slightly brownish. Some more ripe bananas and some very green bananas. Corn, champedak, Bacaurea macrocarpa, some rice of the countless gingers around here, more champedak, champedak, ripe cucumbers used for cooking. Darima Kasi, lots of little catfish from the nearby sea, from the nearby lake. Most of the vendors just sell their stuff on the roadside. Bananas, some sort of swamp plant. This might be some... something of the taro, family. One pineapple, torch ginger, this is actually the most common ginger fruit sold in Borneo. Ripe dried okra, don't even know what they use this for. Some tiny, one tiny pumpkin and a piece of a bigger pumpkin. Again, some cucumbers used for cooking, cucumber seeds. Those are cassava leaves for cooking. Another pumpkin. This could be some either bamboo or heart of palm chopped up for cooking. More pumpkins. This is curcuma, dragon bean. Those could be really small, unripe sour eggplants. This could be some more exotic sweet potato. Some beans or pumpkins. I guess this is wax gourd. More cucumbers, chilies. Rambai. They sell when the rambai is ripe. The fruit season is basically over. And here the fruit season really seems to be towards its end. Different leaves used for cooking. This is cassava leaves. Here again, ferns used for cooking. Curcuma, some tiny limes. White pepper. Guavas in those bags. More ferns in the bags. Here, more ferns. Pumpkin or squash flowers. Normal eggplant. Stink beans. More rambai, rambutan, very small corn. I have no idea why they pick it that small. Some local garlic, here torch ginger and some ginger flowers. They use every part of the ginger for cooking. They want me to show you the Durio Coteensis, really a tasty durian. Darima kasi. Those are probably champedak seeds. When you boil or roast them, they taste like chestnuts. Here the huge smelly bambagan mango, unripe bananas, ripe bananas, and banana flowers. The banana flowers are used as a vegetable for cooking. Here in the plastic bags, dabai, or the Borneo olive, which you also have to cook before you eat it. Some dragon fruit, some eggplant, Ah, terima kasih, mister.
Yeah.
So this is the dabai.
Mayao.
Ah, kembayao. Kembayao is a variety. It's pretty similar to dabai, but different. So this is the kembayao.
Naga.
Naga is their name for the dragon fruit. Naga simply means dragon. Terima kasih, mister. White pepper. Well, the bananas, yeah, basically most of the bananas are being fried. They don't eat so many raw bananas. Again, duriocotenses, corn rambai, or here is some sweet little ginger fruit, like next to the chilies. Here is the local longan. They call longan mata kuching, and this is the variety they know as kakos. More ferns for cooking, rambutan, lemongrass. This swamp vegetable, I don't know. More corn. I hope my phone is focusing. I cannot see anything in the light here. For me, the screen is pretty dark. More ginger flowers and ferns. Papaya leaves used for cooking. Here, usually they cook them, just some papaya leaves with chilies, but if you cook them, like if you cook papaya leaves or unripe papayas with meat, you can actually soften pretty tough and chewy meat. Oh, here they show me, I think this is some cassava roots. They taste more or less like potatoes. Some swamp plant I've seen a lot, but I don't know the name. Here is like some more formal stall, like it's in a house or in a hut at least. Yeah, potatoes. The potatoes look more or less like ours. Here is the tiny pea egg plant. Curcuma, sweet potato leaf. So you cannot eat the leaves of the normal potato. Those are leaves of sweet potatoes or related species. Lemongrass and ginger, chilies, spaghetti beans. Some more young corn, the sour eggplant of Borneo, some tiny onions, garlic, some dried coconuts, again bananas. I think this might be the pisang hotel, and this might be the pisang mas or embun or something. Those are bananas used for cooking. Let's see, one more stall on the other side, like a half formal stall. They are not selling the stuff inside their house, but at least in front of their house on some table-like thing. Not like all the guys over there who just come with an old flour sack or cement sack and put their stuff on it. Well, here they have an old cement sack and put their stuff on it, but let's see what they have. So like some cucumbers pretty similar to ours. Here is again this local longan called kakos. This is some duku langsat, cabbage, some bawang, it's their name for garlic, but it more looks like onion. So different cucumbers, it seems like the long ones, they use them like us as a raw vegetable, but the short ones, they let them get ripe and use them to cook with them. This again seems to be like some sort of, actually this is probably not a normal sweet potato, but morning glory, like a water plant that's related to the sweet potato and where they use the leaves. Here again some dragon bean, rich gourd, chopped up pumpkin, all those chilies, limes. Here rich gourd next to bitter gourd. Some carrots which look more or less like ours. This is one other vegetable. I think this also comes from a swamp and this also used for cooking. Green coconuts for drinking. Let's go around the corner. So we already saw all those informal stalls where they just bring an old sack and put their things on top of it. Oh, they had the They had water apple on a couple of those stalls just 10 minutes ago. They sold them all. Here a shop, here a stall that fries a lot of things. They love frying everything. A stall that sells dried fish. They also love to dry fish. They catch more fish they can eat in a day. They usually dry it. Yeah, here we are like in the half formal section of the market. They have real stalls. Some soybean sprouts, some vegetables, lemongrass, ginger, cucumbers, Sarawak eggplant. This is most probably stink nut, so they peeled it and didn't manage to sell it in time. A lot of the things here look pretty old and dried up. I guess business is not going as planned. Those are some cassava roots. The real reason they grow the cassava for, they don't grow it mostly for the leaves, but for the roots. Here, different eggplants and cucumbers. On the right, the normal eggplant we know in Europe in a slightly different variety. Here, the sour eggplant that tastes completely different and is typical for Borneo. Here, our normal cucumbers in a slightly different variety. Here, the cucumbers used for cooking. Here again, ginger flowers, sweet potatoes. This is some okra taro-like vegetable, but I don't know which one. Here again, cucumber, bitter gourd, rich gourd, spaghetti beans. I don't even know what they have in those little leaf packages. More bananas, more vegetables, more dried fish, potatoes, onions, and carrots that basically look like the ones in Europe. Some nice tomato variety. Oh, here is the fresh catch from the lake. A little fish they haven't dried yet. Tiny little fish here and some slightly bigger ones here. Here again, ferns and other leaves for cooking, bitter gourd, cucumber for cooking, tiny pineapples. More dried fish and those carrots. It's so strange. You have so many exotic stuff and then you see things which could be on every European market. Here is like the center of the village and of the whole region. So here also we have the permanent shops and a couple of restaurants and coffee shops. Actually, basically everyone is selling something. Even look, the hairdresser is also selling drinks. And I bet if he has some ripe fruit in his garden, he will also put it in front of his shop. So this is a small village. People are selling whatever they can. It's not really strict and formal. Oh, what do you have, lady?
Kerupuk basah.
Ah, she has some. Well, I don't know what it is, but I think it's made from cassava. Is it made from cassava or fish cake?
Bahasa Indonesia.
Oh, tidak mengerti bahasa Indonesia. Mengerti sedikit.
Maaf.
So let's see. Over there, second-hand clothing shop. Yeah, this is basically the village center and the center of the whole region. They have some really posh formal market building here, however, they are not using it. It's brand new, but already some of the doors have been ripped out. It's very strange because in those countries, basically, you don't have vandalism. But it seems like they just refuse to use this market building. I don't know why. Maybe they have to pay for it or what. Or maybe some politician has to officially hand it over to them. They are still selling stuff in those makeshift huts and stalls and even on sacks on the ground, but not in the formal market building. Okay, folks, this was like the village market and village center of a typical little village or town in Kalimantan. Stay tuned for more fruit videos from the jungles and occasionally markets of Kalimantan. And don't forget to like, share, comment and subscribe.